Hello, what is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to TTG Plays Nier. Man, we are at the Baron Temple. This place is weird, and, well, let's see what we got here first. I can't remember which way to go, if there is a specific way to go. Basically, what makes this dungeon interesting is that it's a series of puzzle rooms, basically, where you have to use the game's mechanics to do really specific things. Because, before I press this button, the city was all based on rules. And so it makes sense that the temple that they would go to worship is also based entirely on really specific rules. Each room has its own rule, so you have to solve a puzzle using that rule. It's all using the mechanics that the games had all along, which is, once again, I keep bringing this up. The game's combat mechanics, the magic, the way magic works, all of that, all comes into play here in puzzle solving, which I think is brilliant. So, what's this one? Following actions are prohibited in this area. Leaping rabbit. So, what's the leaping rabbit? I have to get through this room without jumping, basically. Now, I can do a regular jump. Nope. Okay. Okay. So, yes. So, what are we supposed to do? Well, this thing's shooting things at us. So we just have to block off its ability to fire. So that's what this whole room is based around, the idea of not being able to shoot. Of course he can sneak behind things and whatever, but yeah. So that's what makes this particular dungeon so cool, to me anyway. Now something I can't do here, I don't think. Yeah, because there's that one there. So what you want to do with this one is pull this down a little bit. Not too far, because you'll go into those ones there and die. Which will also cause you to fail, I believe, if you get hit by those red dots. But yeah, so it's almost like they got all their, the puzzle solving stuff sorted out in this one dungeon, which, you know, I don't actually mind. I think that's pretty neat. I think it's a really cool idea. It has some good puzzles in here. I love the idea of just really specific rules that you have to work around. It's really strict limitations. So, I'll just push this out of the way. And then when you get to the end, you just have to strike the colored cube, and that's the... Whoops, I almost ran into those bullets a little early. There we go. Solved! O master of the trial, it is time to devote yourself to the next rule.
I wonder what this missing prince is like. The man is tasked to protect his people, and yet they toil to save him. I think that tells us everything we need to know. Just a foolhardy band of rescuers, don't mind us.
Someone's here.
Okay, so that door over there is still sealed, so I think I have to go through this one next, since it's the only one that's not sealed. Oh, that's not a thing. Remembering my way around, that's the real fun part. So I can't come through... Oh wait, now it's open. I just have to wait for that dialogue to finish, okay.
Where did you come from, boy?
I am the 93rd Prince of Arcade.
Huh? But you're just a kid.
Silence, how could you know so little in the way of...
Huh?
Huh? What is this thing? Remember that time the cube stole someone? That was then. Alright, next puzzle room. What's the rule for this one? The following actions are prohibited in this room. Stationary owl. Oh yeah, I'm not allowed to stand still. You have to keep moving. The puzzle's a little bit dumb. It's literally you just have to keep moving, but it doesn't really give you enough time to observe the things around you. To a degree where you can not run into bullets. But we did it, because we're amazing. And now we got a little bit of platforming, just, you know, for good measure. Alright, well, let's see what's in here. You don't have to show me the door closing every time, I get it. I get it. It is... The following actions are prohibited in this room. Racing wolf, magic spewing bat.
God damn it! This shit's starting to piss me off!
Kaine!
What in the... Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Let me go! Let me... I am gonna kill you!
I assume we'll have to find her as well.
Yep.
Okay. So. Wait, whoa, whoa. Is Racing Wolf running? I'm not allowed to... Yeah, you're not allowed to run in this room. Okay. What I can do is... Whoops. It's so easy to just press too far on the stick. So the way you have to get through this whole room is a bit of a pain. This is one that I know everyone hates. God damn it. I'm just gonna walk casually. You kinda have to get through the whole thing while holding your block. Because of course if you get hit by a thing, you're dead. So I'm actually gonna fast forward through this room because it's not very exciting. Hey, we made it! As annoying as that is, like, it's not hard at all. And I think it being dumb and annoying is kind of the point. A lot of people complain about that stuff, but I don't think it's a case of the game director, like, not knowing that those ideas are, like, inherently bad. It's very much putting deliberately bad things in there to prove a point, almost. But that doesn't... That's not a justification for them. It doesn't make them better all of a sudden, which is something that some people do argue. I think a bad idea is a bad idea, no matter what the context is. But I think it is interesting that they've tried to use bad gameplay designs to kind of like emphasize how dumb like all these crazy rules are that these guys have. The whole action's prohibited in this room. Protected turtle. Alright, so I'm not allowed a shield in this room. Oh god. Yeah, I there's no way you can magic your way out of this one. Oh, and now I'm dead. Yeah, this shit's intense. You kind of end up having to, from memory, like, do it a little bit at a time. Because it's that one. I think I can get up one more. Nope. Oh yeah, I can probably heal while I'm here. If it'll let me, there we go. Alternatively, I believe you can actually make your way onto this guy here. Oh. Oh, they disappear after a second. Oof, yes, we did it. I'm too smart. Too smart for you, game. I didn't expect that to work. I thought I'd failed that. I thought I would get hit by a ball, but it was actually the... When you stand on those blocks, obviously they must explode because I don't want you to cheat your way through it too much. Although, obviously, they knew that that's what some people would do. It's possible, I guess, that they actually put that there. Those blocks there to try to push as, like, the hard way. And, like, let's see if people will work out the easy way to do this, which is just to jump over all of it. Alright, what's the rule here? Let's find out! It is... If it'll stop spinning around. Following actions are prohibited in this room. Magic Spearing Bat. Okay. Whoops. That didn't work as planned. So I can... Damn it. Ah, so close. There are some of these that you can jump on and some that you can't. So these ones don't disappear, but the actual cannons themselves do disappear if you take too long to jump off of them. Which, you know. Oh, crap! So goddamn close. Let's try this one more time. Well, no, not one more time. I'm gonna keep going until I succeed, but you know what I mean. Whoop. Yeah, the controls in terms of platforming aren't ideal, to say the least. Yes, we did it. All I have to do is jump on it, really? Yeah, I didn't know that. And I need a heal again. I'm like sitting here slamming the D-pad. There we go. Thank you very much for letting me actually use that item. Yeah, I'm having a blast doing this stuff. I think these are great. Oh, I remember this room well. I remember this one giving me some grief. Bladewielding Tiger. Okay, so I don't think.
Rules shows no signs of slowing.
Stop talking, Max. We're gonna mess this up again.
The masked people certainly do enjoy their rules.
What a pain. Whoever came up with this system must be soft in the head.
Okay, now. So this one's really all just about destroying all of the purple ones without getting hit. Maybe it wasn't this one, but another one that was similar to it that I got grief with. Not that I had grief with, but that gave me a hard time. Whoa! Sometimes it becomes a matter of, like, knowing where they are as well, because they kind of, like, these things disappear and reappear. I'm sure I've missed some in here somewhere. I have to check the other side. Yeah, still some left. Is that one up here somewhere, or is it just exploding? Oh, there we go. Yeah, we got them all. Alright, probably wasn't that one then. Ooh la la. It's like constant wondering of just like, oh, what awaits? What's gonna happen next? What's it gonna throw at us? Super Mario Brothers is a saint. Actually, wouldn't mind a Zelda game having a control scheme similar to this. I know, like, Link doesn't need to jump, but I think the way they integrate this, the jumping into the combat, is more than enough to justify the act of having a jumping being a thing you can do. Hey, what's this? That'll be fine. If I can fucking click on it. Thank you. I know. Thank you very much. I'll take it. What have we got here? Something good, I hope. Following actions are prohibited in this room. Evasive mouse. Oh, no dodging. Oh. Alright, here's where the combat starts in here again. Gotta get through all these guys without dodging. That I can do. I don't dodge that much anyway, so that's not a big... Not a big deal. Oh, that didn't do as much damage as I thought it would. Oh, crap. Damn it. Instinct. Well, it's still the cheap and easy way. Yo, magic. Really nice if some of you guys could drop some medicinal herbs. I could really use some. Ooh, item drop rate up by 4%. That sounds good. That I'm down with. Whoa, guys. These guys are being very aggressive. Come on. Just follow me, guys. Follow the black magic bullets. And there is a thing. Oh, shit. I did not remember this. Oh, this is not something I want to do without dodging. Actually, this guy's not so bad. Whoa, I spoke too soon. Word obtained, the word Connor. Magic defense, weapons, magic paralyze. Oh, cool. Well, I got some new words to equip, so I might quickly go into the menu and do that. Alright, she's all fixed up. Just had a look at this weapon stats too. It's actually pretty easy to upgrade this thing, which is nice. Oh, where are we now? Oh, we're down here now. Okay, well, that's fair. I guess that makes sense. Yeah, this weapon only really needs a single complex machine and some iron ore to upgrade, which I kind of regret selling all that iron ore to buy it now. That would have been handy. Although I didn't have a complex machine, I don't think, so maybe wouldn't have been that handy. Alright, let's see what's in here. At the end of this very long bridge. My guess is a boss. That was a save point. That's usually a good sign that there's a boss coming up. Alright, let's go.
Where are we? It's an odd place to be sure. I suppose that was to be expected.
Look!
Inside. Without any rules to bind us, we are free to unleash the entirety of our powers.
Less thinking, more killing. I like it. What is this?
Alright, so this is the boss for this dungeon, and it is one that I actually had quite a lot of trouble with the first time through. My first time playing through this temple, I really struggled to beat this guy for whatever reason. He seems pretty easy now, but I remember him getting quite difficult later on. I don't think I can use this on this, can I? No. I gotta swap that magic out for a Dark Lance. Whoops. Yeah, it's pretty tough, because well, the boss itself isn't tough, but actually getting attacking the stuff at the right time is. The colored boxes send out the dark orbs, which I remember talking to you about, mentioning in like a different episode, about the fact that they can't be blocked with your magic the way other orbs can. Which makes them quite dangerous in a lot of ways. Ugh. I don't think I can shoot through, no. So these keep changing now, which also makes them, you know, a little bit tougher to keep track of. Also, my health is getting really low. I do not have many healing items, which is bad. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. So few healing items. Actually, I might just dodge stuff for a little while, and then I'll wait for my magic to build right up so I can... Here we go. Perfect. Wait for this thing to come back around. Yeah, perfect. Oh, did nice dodge there, Dan. Good one. Oh, it changed. Prick. Still got it, though. One left. Nice. You got... Alright, now to the next one. This is where it gets tricky when they all start changing. You get so many of these black ones coming up. Oh, sorry about that, and all of a sudden my nose has gotten very sniffly. This one also moves very, very slowly, which, as you can imagine, is kind of annoying. I'm sure this one's not as bad as the last one, now that's kind of easier to predict. Oh, jeez. Well, I say that, now I start getting my ass handed to me, of course. Alright. Okay. No, this is actually the easy bit. It's just spewing out so much shit. Busted. Yeah, so I can kind of see how this thing's escalating. This is still not even the hard part of the boss, ironically. Not by a long shot. This is definitely the boss that I had the most trouble with through the game, though. Oh, crap. I didn't even see that coming, that black one. Oh, fuck. Let's... use those herbs. Oh, no, I'm all... I've got one heal left. I'm not even up to the hard bit... Fuck. I'm not even up to the hard bit of the boss yet. Bad. Bad news, Betty. Lock this shit. I can. Alright. Oh, fuck. I literally had it lined up and then it changed. That's annoying. That's the thing about this son of a bitch. He's always switching. You're just kind of waiting for it to be the one in the front. Yes! Ah, you fucking prick. Ah, god damn it. Thing is, there's no safe place to like stand either. It's just kind of like fire, and they slowly, their health goes down, and just keep your eyes open for the big black ones because you can't defend against those, and they'll just slowly whittle their health down. You can't say it's not an interesting boss, at least. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's, right, one recovery potion. Sorry if I'm very quiet. This boss is, yeah. It's like that. Right, can I get over the other side? Not that I want to be running through all this shit and losing all my health and stuff, but... No, I can't. It's just there for the look. Yeah, so the blue ones you can't hurt, period. You can only hurt it when it's pink. The thing about that is, when it's rotating like this and it's constantly changing... It's obviously pretty hard to... actually hit the fucking thing. Yeah, definitely, in my books, the most difficult boss in the game. Hey, we got one! I didn't even notice. So much shit going on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! Yep, ow. Oh, I can defend against the black ones. I didn't know that. Now I know that. Okay, good. Yes, two down. Doesn't stop them shooting catalyst shit at me. One more! And I'm dead. Alright, there's only two left. We got this fucking crap. Maybe not. I think this time we're gonna do it this time. It's gonna be awesome. Just you watch. Damn it. It's just the last second there, too. Damn it. Come on. Switch, please. Nope. It's gonna switch, but it's too late. I knew it. Damn it. Too early. Yeah, I kinda got this part of the boss worked out a little bit better now. It's just a matter of waiting. Playing the waiting game. Picking your moment. There we go. Alright, so we got past that first form. Now for the hard part. And at this point, I've already almost used up most of my my potions, so... Oh, God.
The guardian of this temple is a joke, sight indeed.
Says the talking book.
Yeah, so this guy's pretty, Shockwaves and shit. Usual suspects. Whoa. Ow. It's been a while, so I don't exactly remember what he does. He does bad's what he does. He's a tough motherfucker. Alright, let's heal up. Maybe this time we'll make it. I doubt it. I get the feeling I'm going to be replaying this boss again. Just like last time. Hardest boss in the game, in my opinion.
This is a powerful foe.
Kaine?
Stay there! I'll take care of this loser!
Oh yeah, alright. We're actually doing pretty good now. He's getting there. He's getting a little bit lower. I guess this isn't the hard part. Or is it? This guy's got a whole bunch of different, like, stages. Alright. Oh, I really thought he was gonna, turn pink there, but he's doing his little finger trick. Which is a lot easier now that he's lost most of his fingers. Hard to deny that. Much, much easier, actually. Yeah, I just love the bosses in this game. They're also specifically and unique. Whoa. We do not want to get hit with that shockwave if we can avoid it. And he has now lost that hand. Oh, his alarm fell off. I didn't remember that. Now that's what I'm talking about. Oh yeah, come on. No shockwave that time? Alright, I'm cool with that. Now, what does he do from here? Well, I'm glad you asked, because you're about to see. Fucking Christ. I remember this now. Let's just do that, I think is the best way. We'll rely on our magic dark lance. Ah, crap, missed it. Yeah, dark lance is definitely your best bet for the... It's easy to be tempted to just like spam your dark blasts, but ow, jeez. I definitely think that the dark lance is the way to go. If you can predict where the stuff's gonna be. That seems to be a big part of it, is actually predicting whereabouts the yeah, once we get rid of this last one, that should all stop. Yes! Alright, that's the outer layer busted. Personally, I'm a fan of trying to get these things taken care of before it gets a chance to do anything horrible to me. Whether or not I can succeed is something else entirely. Yeah, I remember my first time trying to play through this, like, I just stuck with my Dark Blast and, this fight took the longest time. Just because the accuracy on it's so, the accuracy and the power on it's so low, whereas with this, it's one hit. Alright, we're getting very close now, come on. I love the fact he doesn't have this brief invincibility period. It's just like, oh, what's this? Is that the next level? It's going pink. Just attack him. Just kill him. Oh shit, that's gonna hit me. One more. Alright, we're done with the inner ring. This has been a hell of a boss fight. Make magic to charge back up again. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. He's almost done. You just gotta believe, Dan. You just gotta believe. There was another Zelda reference coming up, but I didn't tell you which episode. That was the big one. That's the biggest nod of all. I love that. It's like the exact same music, and it's just like a... at the end. I love that.
Kaidam.
Prince!
Yuri.
My liege. Have you any idea what the trouble with... Ah. The royal musk. Our people have suffered since the king's death. I was too young to bridge the gap between our people and other civilizations. Trade has come to a halt. We lack food and water, and the people despair for it. This musk is an emblem of the king. With it, I can project a strong image to other lands, and our people can be prosperous once more. My prince, rules do not exist to bind you. They exist so you may know your freedoms. Those are the words of the previous king, my father. And now that I have this mask, I believe I can ascend to the throne. Is this correct? Of course. Hail! All hail the new king! Alright. I apologize to you, my foreign friends, for all your hardships. I swear by my new position as the King of Fakade, I shall grant whatever you desire. Please, what is it I can do for you?
I appreciate the offer, but I'll have to pass. My wish... Well, it kind of has to take care of itself.
Kosa.
Then think of a wish I can grant on behalf of another.
I think he just gave us an order.
A new wish. Fine. I want you to make rule zero. And it's gonna say that if people don't like a rule, they can vote to change it.
A splendid idea.
Yorisaro. Very well. What? But my king, this cannot be. Our people have long memories. We shall never forget the debt we owe you, no matter how hard the times. Such is the way of the masked people. And thus, we shall grant your request. Still, that alone cannot repay our debt to you. Please accept this. Obtain the one-hand sword rebirth.
But I think you're forgetting someone.
Thank you, Fyra. And I'm sorry for all I put you through. It's not a problem. I'd like to ask you about the Black Scroll. Yes, the foul disease that claimed my father's life. We heard that you were searching for a cure. Did you ever learn anything? I'm sorry, no. Everything we tried ended in failure. It seems there's no way around it. We'll have to collect the sealed verses one by one. Yeah, thankfully there aren't too many left. Pardon me, but what are these sealed verses? We're not sure, but if I find them, I can save my daughter from the Black Scroll. You don't know what they are? I don't know. And I don't much care. I just want to save my daughter. I'll run around collecting a bunch of crystal horse manure if that's what it takes. I think that's... I'm sorry we couldn't be more help. Yeah, that's everything. One moment, please. Oh. Can I ask you to visit us again? To return as friends?
Sure. Why not?
Just try not to get yourself kidnapped again,
Oh, thank you. And I promise to be careful. Dark wall magic. Erect a magical defensive barrier. Alright. Well, that's cool. Well, now we've done that, let's,
I'm worried about Yona. Let's go back.
Whoops. Let's get out of here. Let's skedaddle. Skadoodle. Alright, I'm gonna, just quickly travel back to Yona, and then we're gonna call it an episode. It's been a big one, this one. Well, it has for me, anyway. I recorded for a little longer than I was expecting. Mainly because of that boss fight. Oh yeah, we got a new weapon. Let's have a look at it. See how it compares to our current, current weapon. We got the Rebirth, which... only does 115. But let's have a look at it. Oh, it's a chakram. Cool. So where's... Oops. So my weapon collection is only at 70%. This game does have a lot of different weapons. But... yeah, so in here you can also see what you need to, in order to, upgrade them. Actually, each one also has, like, a bit of text. Let's look at this. The Nameless Blade, a simple sword forged by a village smith, more suited to fending off small animals than actual combat. So that's what we started with. Then there's the Nirvana Dagger. A group of girls use the sword to consecrate a newly built temple with their own blood. Kinda a little gross. Then there's the Moonrise, which was one we were using for the longest time. A weapon owned by a blind swordsman. The blind shines in darkness, making the owner easy to spot. So, that was a, yeah, even at level 2, like, that doesn't upgrade too good. Then you got the Rebirth. A unique sword that's a round blade. Legend holds that it robs the wielder of its life force. I almost have enough to upgrade that. That's kind of neat. And then there's the Beast Bane, which is a sword that bears a beastly motif. Its short, thin blade seems eager to vanish from sight. So yeah, that's just a little bit of lore there on the weapons we have. But yeah, let's see out here. I'm sure Kaine's out here. And yeah, let's head back to the village.
I fear for the future of Fassad. No matter how good his intentions with a king so young.
The people will make up for whatever the king lacks.
I imagine we'll come back to a whole new slew of rules.
Probably. The rules seem to work for them, so who are we to say otherwise?
Oh, come now.
There are as many ways to view the world as there are people in it.
Perhaps you have learned something on this journey after all.
Maybe. What do you think, Kaine?
Don't care.
And we are back in the village. Good to be home. Always good to be home. Let's go check up on Yuna and then we'll call it an episode. Ooh, let's see what treats are waiting for us in here today. 700 gold, very nice. What else we got? Defense drop, which is, I sold a whole bunch of those, so that's not a bad thing. Hey, Yuna, what's up? Yuna! Oh, hi, Dad. How are you feeling? I'm okay. Sometimes it still hurts, but that fish medicine you got helps a lot. Good. Dad, are you gonna stay here tonight? Yeah. Yay, Dad's going to stay home tonight. Easy, Yuna. You'll hurt something. Teehee, I don't care. I'm just happy I get to see you. It's late. You should go to bed. Okay. Night, Dad. Andrew's thinking, in the Japanese version, Nier isn't an old man. He's actually a younger guy. Much more classically anime handsome guy. That's Yona's brother instead of a father. And they changed it to the father for the worst because I thought that we'd enjoy that more. I don't think people did, but I definitely think that made it more interesting. But anyway, I hear a voice. I squinted to see a boy standing before me. His hair is silver, his skin is pale, and he stares up at me with hard glassy eyes. Soon his lips begin to move, but no sound comes out. What is he saying? I can't hear him. I can't hear him. I can't hear him. I can't hear him. I can't. I can't. I can't. I try to leave, but something about the boy holds my gaze. I watch his face, expressionless, as his lips slowly flutter. What is he trying to say? Wait, it's a phrase. I can almost make it out. It starts with an S, and then there's an E. I can almost see it now. The letters begin to fall together, one after the other, faster and faster. Sealed verse. Oh my god, it's a sealed verse. The thing I'm looking for, the key to saving my little girl. I stare at the boy with renewed ferocity, trying desperately to make out his next word. Dream. Dream? Dream what? What the hell does that mean? The lips move again, faster now. I can't follow them, damn it. I can't make it out. I want to scream, I want to tear the walls down around me, but instead I force myself to be calm. I can do this. I can do it for Yuna. Slowly, ever so slowly, I pass out the letters that make up his final words. Forest of Myth. Well, that's hinting at quite a couple of different things that'll be coming up in the future. Very, very interesting. What does it all mean? Well, that was a messed up dream. I never thought I'd be hunting sealed verses in there.
Oh.
Morning, Dad. Hey. What's wrong? You look all tired. And you have these weird black circles under your eyes. It's nothing. I had a strange dream, and I didn't sleep very well. Oh, I have weird dreams all the time. I know. Actually, I had a totally weird dream last night. Oh, did you now? There was a boy and me, and we were playing this game together. What kind of game? It was called Guess the Word. I think he made it up because I never heard of it before. How did it work? Well, the boy would move his mouth, but no words would come out, so I had to guess what he was trying to say. It was hard. I wanted to play hide and seek, but we had to play this dumb game instead. What did he say? I don't know. All I could figure out was dream and forest of myth. But he said he'd be back, so I got to study. Then I could figure out everything and win. You gonna help me study, right, Dad? Yeah, sure. Well, she's had the same dream that you did. Very, very interesting. What does it all mean? Well, maybe we'll find out in the next episode. You appear lost in thought. This frightens me. It's nothing. Don't worry about it. Come on, I need to go ask Popple or something. Yes, yes indeed. What does it all mean? I guess you'll have to find out next time. So thank you for joining me. This was a long one. I hope that's okay with all of you. So thanks for joining me. If you're enjoying the series, give it a like to let me know, and I'll catch you next time. Peace out, and have a good one.